In the last video, we have seen that chromosomes are found in the nucleus and are visible only when a cell nucleus is about to divide. And it is the chromatin fibers that condense to form chromosomes. Chromosomes are composed of long strands of DNA, and a gene is a piece of DNA or is a DNA segment which determines the hereditary characteristics. Simply, genes are the units of heredity. Now, every gene has two alternative forms for a character producing different effects. These alternative forms are called the alleles. For example, the gene for eye color has several alleles, such as an allele for blue eye color or an allele for brown eyes color. Out of the two alleles of a gene, one is dominant, that is super ruling, or the one that is expressed, while the other is recessive or subordinate. Here are some more examples of gene and their alleles. For height, in pea plant, the two alleles are tall or dwarf. For wing type in fruit fly, the two alleles are normal or vestigial. For seed color in maize, the two alleles are purple or yellow. Let us take a look at the picture to gain a better understanding about gene, its allele, and it being dominant or recessive. In this picture, we are discussing a character eye color. There is a gene that controls this character. Now, there are several variants or traits to this eye color, that is blue, black, green, etc. Hence, there will be an allele for each. Example, an allele for blue eye color or an allele for brown eye color. We see here that capital B is the dominant brown allele, while small b is the recessive blue eye allele. Thus, for the phenotype eye color brown, there are two genotypes, that is capital B, and capital B, small b, while for blue, it is only small b, small b. The brown eye color allele is dominant over the blue eye color allele, hence it expresses itself over the blue eye color in heterozygous condition. The blue eye color is expressed only in homozygous recessive condition, because in heterozygous condition, it is masked by the dominant allele. Let us take a look at another simple example. In the character of tongue rolling, there are two possibilities. Either one can roll the tongue or one cannot. Thus, there are two alleles, one for rolling and the other for non-rolling. Genotype and phenotype. The three situations pertaining to any pair of genes, as for example, in tongue rolling, can be as follows. Capital R, both dominant, the individual is a tongue roller. Capital R, small r, that is one dominant, one recessive, the individual is still a tongue roller. Small r, both recessive, the individual is a non-roller. You can see from the above that tongue rollers have two kinds of genetic constitution, whereas non-rollers have only one. The genetic constitution are called genotype, and the expressed characteristic is called the phenotype. Rules for the inheritance of traits, Mendel's contribution. The basic principles of genetics were discovered for the first time by Gregor Mendel. Gregor Mendel was not primarily a biologist, but an Austrian monk. He published the result of his meticulous work in 1866. But its significance was not realized till 1900. Today, Mendel is considered to be the father of genetics. Mendel was keenly interested in plant breeding and was fascinated by the regular and predictable results he obtained. He conducted breeding experiments on garden pea, Picum sativum. Mendel selected 7 distinct traits from 34 varieties of garden pea that he collected. The contrasting traits studied by Mendel in pea were as follows: seed shape, round or wrinkled, seed color, yellow or green, pod color, green or yellow, pod shape, inflated or constricted, stem height, tall or dwarf, flower position, axial or terminal, flower color, purple and white. It was not by accident that Mendel selected pea as his experimental plant. Mendel selected the garden pea as the flowers of this plant are so structured that stamens and pistils are completely enclosed by petals, and hence the flowers are normally self-pollinated. But at the same time, the pea flowers could be easily cross-pollinated or hybridized by hand for experiments. It was done by removing the stamens, that is by emasculation, before the pistil of the flower matured and then dusting the stigma of the flower with pollens of another desired pea plant. Other reasons for a selection were many easily identifiable and contrasting characters are present in pea plant. They produce large number of offspring. Pea plants grow very fast and seeds do not show dormancy. Mendel's experiment. Mendel crossed pure breeding varieties by taking only one feature at a time and then by taking two features, that is monohybrid and dihybrid crosses. First, we will talk about monohybrid cross. Monohybrid cross refers to crossing by taking only one feature at a time. Mendel tried monohybrid cross with all the seven features and his observations were similar for all. Pure tall, that is capital T, capital T pea plants were crossed with pure dwarf pea, that is small t plants. The gametes produced by pure tall are capital T and capital T and by pure dwarf are small t and small t. By plotting a Punnett square, the phenotypic ratio obtained in the F1 is 4:0, that is 4 tall and none dwarf. Similarly, the genotypic ratio remains 4:0, that is 4 heterozygous tall individuals. In all F1, all offspring show dominant traits. On selfing, we get F2 generation. The gametes produced are capital T and small t, and again capital T and small t. On plotting Punnett square, the phenotypic ratio obtained is 3:1, that is 3 tall and 1 dwarf. The genotypic ratio obtained is 1:2:1, that is 1 homozygous tall, that is capital T, capital T, 2 heterozygous tall, that is capital T, small t, 1 homozygous dwarf, that is small t, small t. This picture summarizes the F1 and F2 generation obtained in a monohybrid cross. When purebred plants were crossbred, the offspring of this cross are all hybrids showing only the dominant traits and are called the first filial or F1 generations. Now we will discuss the dihybrid ratio. It refers to crossing by taking two pairs of contrasting characters. The phenotypic ratio obtained is 9:3:3:1. The genotypic ratio is very complex. The two pair of contrasting characters here are seed color and seed shape. The round shape and yellow seed color is dominant over wrinkled seed shape and green seed color. In the F1 generation, all round and yellow color seeds are obtained as we know that dominant is expressed. In F2 generation, the following results are obtained. 9 out of 16 are round and yellow. 3 out of 16 are round and green. 3 out of 16 are wrinkled and yellow. And only 1 out of 16 is wrinkled and green. Now, the question arises that, how do these traits get expressed? Well, the gene serves as instruction books for making functional molecules such as RNA and proteins. The genes produce the protein, which in turn controls the characteristics or traits. In the next video, we will discuss Mendel's law of inheritance.